So let's look at the last type of phase portrait, one for spiral points. Here the differential equation is x1 dot equals minus 1 half x1 plus x2. x2 dot equals minus x1 minus 1 half x2. The matrix is minus 1 half 1, minus 1, minus 1 half. If you do the eigenvalue and eigenvector analysis on that matrix, you get a complex conjugate eigenvalues. So the, one of the eigenvalues is minus 1 half plus I, and its associated eigenvector is 1i. And then you have the complex conjugate pair. If we write the solution by constructing two real solutions, we'll end up with x equals this decaying exponential times a times this cosine t minus sine t plus b times the sine t cosine t. This type of solution is circular, and then it's having a exponential decay. So this is why you get a spiral. So let me show you what the solution might look like. Right? So the origin is the fixed point, and it's decaying exponentially, so the fixed point is stable. And the solution spiraling into the origin. So it could look something like this, right? And then you spiral into the origin. And because it's stable, it's going in. But we're not really sure this is what it looks like, because there's two ways to spiral into the origin. This is one of the ways. Here you see that the motion is, if you look like a clock, this is clockwise, right? So this is a clockwise spiral. On the other hand, if we have a counterclockwise spiral, so remember this is x1 and x2, x1 and x2, a counterclockwise spiral will be spiraling into the origin, but in the other direction, right? Like so. So the solution can look like one of these. It's a spiral into the origin, right? But could be clockwise, or in this case, it's counterclockwise. So how do you tell which one it is? The simplest way is just to look at the point on the x2 axis. So here we have x1 equal to 0, right, at that point, and here also. If we look at x1 equal to 0, then we have x1 dot equals x2. So x1 dot equals x2, meaning that you're moving to the right, right? So in the top diagram, the trajectory is moving towards the right. In the bottom diagram, the trajectory is moving to the left. So if we substitute in x1 equals 0, x2 is positive, then x1 dot is positive here, right? And it should be. That's correct. But here, x1 dot is negative. So this one is incorrect, right? This one is correct. Okay. Let's look at a computer-generated phase portrait using MATLAB. So here you see how the trajectories are all spiraling into the origin. Okay, so let me review. In this last and final case, we considered spiral points. Here, the eigenvalues are complex. They show up as complex conjugate pairs. The key here is the real part of the eigenvalue. So if the real part is negative, then this is a stable spiral. All solutions spiral into the origin. If the real part is positive, then this is an unstable spiral. All solutions spiral out of the origin. Then you have two choices, whether it's a clockwise spiral or a counterclockwise spiral. You can determine which one it is by examining the differential equation. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.